The Deputy Governor, Dr. Michael Atingi Ego, who led a team, responded that the claims are not true, saying the bank has guiding principles followed when printing money.
The government is aware of the consequences of printing money, the inflationary aspect of it, so government cannot go and do that. So that's not true, at least from my standpoint.
Dr. Atingi explains how the Russia and Ukraine war and the drought that hit the country contributed to the inflation rate that went up last year to 10.7%.
A number of small businesses were affected by COVID-19 and are struggling to recover. So we had come to explain to the people of Soroti that we have some facilities that they could take advantage of and access them in order to help their business recover from the devastating impact of COVID-19.
He implored the Teso community to venture into agro-processing for value addition to their produce. He noted that this can be achieved when people embrace services such as Agriculture Credit Facility, ACF, that the government set up in 2009 with an aim of facilitating the provision of medium and long-term financing to projects engaged in agriculture and agro-processing, focusing mainly on commercialization and value addition.
But we have tried to, as much as possible, put in policies in place. And as you're aware, inflation has begun to come down. It increased from about 2.7 in January 2022. It hit 10.7% in October. But as we talk right now, it's down.
During the engagements, commercial banks were accused of giving people loans with very high interest. Wilbord Owor, the executive director of Uganda Bankers Association, an umbrella body of commercial banks, promised to take the matter up to save farmers. Owor promised to address the issue of collateral that banks have sold off.
Require more information. Some of them require on our side, on the commercial banks, to make some changes and accommodations. The one that touched me particularly was the agricultural loan, the agricultural facility loan, where some of the businesses said they are required to pay monthly. Typically, agricultural loans, the repayment should be structured per season.
The Deputy Governor expressed gratitude to the people of Teso for their feedback and promised that the bank will take their concerns into consideration for better working relationships. Report by Godfrey Ojore for the news.